And hello again, everybody. High above the ice alongside Andy Brickley with Sophie Yurkshevich. I'm Jack Edwards. Well, if we go into Mr. Peabody's Wayback Machine, 8 games ago and 6 games ago against Nashville and then Washington, the Bruins were bashing bodies and they were playing to their standard. Now, not so much the 60-minute effort.
Yeah, and that's the way it's going to be throughout the regular season, Jack. There will be games where you disappoint. You disappoint your fan base. More importantly, you disappoint yourselves. And that's what happened on the last game of that 3-game road trip against Dallas. Important that Boston put their best game or their best skate forward, beat a team that's below them, far below them in the standings, continue to improve your home record, and go into that All-Star break feeling good about where you are at this point in the season.
Legendary radio commentator Paul Harvey spoke with a cadence that had great pauses because the audience hangs on the last thing he said in the pause. If the Bruins lose, this will resonate throughout the All-Star break. That's not the way they want to go into this mini vacation.
Yeah, you think back when the Bruins were in a stretch. They won 8 out of 9. They had a home game against Carolina. It was an embarrassing performance for the Boston Bruins. They lose 7-1. They were never really in the hockey game. And the question is, how do you respond? How much mental toughness do you have? The Washington Capitals come in right after the Hurricanes, and the Bruins play with a purpose. They took hits, they gave hits. They competed for pucks. They competed for pucks when it was a foot race or when it was a puck battle along the wall. You know, Washington is a heavy, talented team, and the Bruins matched them. They almost didn't care who the opponent was going to be after that game against Carolina. They wanted to go out, play their game. When the game was in the balance in the third period, Charlie McAvoy steps up with a power play goal. They got goals from Pastrnak. They got a goal from Jake DeBrusk. But they played the style of hockey that they wanted to play. Tonight, doesn't matter who the opponent is. Beat this team, a team you should beat. And Jack, good day.
Well done. We're playing Predict the Game tonight. Go to nest.com/predict the game to win a Patrice Bergeron signed puck and $250. Will an ex-Bruin record a point for the Kraken tonight? That's our first question. The Bruins face Seattle of all teams. We're back in a flash.
School, at work, and beyond. Please welcome Nicole Talbot.
Oh, can you see? What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleam, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
tonight's starting goaltenders brought to you by Jordan's Furniture, not just a store, experience. And Seattle has looked like an expansion team in front of him. Not pretty numbers. Linus Ullmark lit it up in January. An 8-1-1 record with a sub-3 goals against average and a .900 save percentage. This is the first ever meeting between these two franchises. Dave Hackstall, the ex-North Dakota and Philadelphia Flyers coach, behind the bench. The game is on. Taylor Hall flips it forward. Bruin, now Seattle Kraken. Jeremy Lauzon ices the puck. Lauzon picked off in the expansion draft. Jay Leach, the assistant coach, had input. There's Jay Leach. Vince Dunn to Ryan Donato, another ex-Bruin. Jonas Donskoy, Donato backhand through the crease. Lauzon kicks it and sticks it. Carlo, long shot on Drieger, turns it aside for Dunn. Alexander Wenberg to Donato, twists the wrists and gives the puck to Lauzon. Both teams change out. Here's Mason Appleton, ex-Winnipeg Jet. Olmark around the boards. Yarncroc to Gord. Giordano's high drive. Gord protects the puck against McAvoy, whips it around. Adam Larson to Yanni Gord, who has his name on the cup a couple of times with Tampa Bay. Kalle Yarncroc, who has played some really good hockey against Boston when he was with Nashville. Dunn holds Jordan Eberle, racing diagonally toward the attacking line. Johansson can't penetrate. Good bounce for Boston off the linesman's leg. Carlo paddles it, and Bergeron's shot deflects past the far post. Bergeron closes. The doorstep tip by Marchand goes away. Dunn, the backhand. Marcus Johansson, Jared McCann toe picks and falls flat. Marchand in transition waves it off the end glass. Bergeron right through the crease. Vaakanainen, the shot makes the strings tremble. Vaakanainen gets mashed as he tries to center it. And here's Hayden Fleury. Fleury gets his own dump in as Seattle changes out behind him. Forbert off bleed. Giordano cross ice. Riley Sheahan can't make much of it. Sheahan gets the puck back. Gets hauled down by Anton Bleed, and Seattle's going to go on the power play.
Yeah,
a tripping call.
Yeah, just going to comment. The Bruins got a couple of good breaks, Jack. The one you pointed out off the linesman allowed him some possession through the neutral zone.
Boston 81, minor penalty tripping.
And then the other was the potential 2-on-1 when McCann fell down, you know, just toe-picked in the neutral zone. That was a good break. But this is not a good break. On the back check, Anton Bleed. Riley Sheahan fights his way through two Bruin defenders as he tries to make a play on the puck. Bleed's stick gets in the way. He'll go to the box with an early power play for the Kraken.
Seattle has gone 2-for-25 in its last 7 games. Giordano's shot blocked by Bergeron. He breaks forward with Marchand. Bergeron closes. Doesn't get a shot off. Marchand Nobody is better at puck retrieval than Brad Marchand.
And a pretty good effort there, too, by Bergeron. He held the puck. The passing lane to Marchand wasn't there. He tried to go backhand, forehand, get a quick release. The puck slid off the blade of his stick.
Everly to Johansson to McCann. Johansson, the doorstep tip by Everly.
Well-executed rush on the power play. Pretty good opportunity for a pretty good goal scorer in Everly.
Six times a 20-goal scorer, Jordan Everly. Ryan Donato, who can shoot, as we all know. 4 years ago, he was preparing for the Olympics. Curtis Lazar clears. Lazar turns 27 tomorrow. Vince Dunn, who ran St. Louis's power play very well in 2019. Morgan Geeky to Dunn. Wennberg back to Dunn. Wennberg looks for a seam. Turns it back to the perimeter. Dunn to Wennberg. He closes. The tip by Donato. Two shots and a couple of stops by Ullmark. Dunn, the no-look pass to Geeky. Fires it wing to wing. Wennberg picks it up on a bounce. Gives back to Dunn. Fires it off of Vakanainen's leg. Wennberg dangles the puck. Good stick by DeBrusk, deflecting the puck out of play with 4 seconds left on Bleed's trip.
A couple quality scoring chances for the power play for the Kraken. One is right here off the rush. Johansson, McCann, Everly on the net drive. Bruins don't pick him up. They try to be aggressive. They overload the one side. That leaves open ice for Everly, who gets beyond Noshik. His redirect wide on the glove side. And then Donato had a chance on the Wennberg drive from the left elbow. Tried for the tip, tried for the rebound.
Three shots during the power play. It's not icing as the Bruins released the puck before Bleed got out of the gate. Hayden Fleury behind Mason Appleton. Carlo Pasternak. Now Tomas Nosek leaves it for Taylor Hall. Carlo off the corner boards. Pasternak picks it up far side. Appleton deflects the puck to center. Pasternak, second effort, gets it to Hall. Trickles it up the boards. Nosek pivots. Colin Blackwell, his first touch. Taylor Hall, a good bounce for Boston, but he couldn't cash in. The tip by Nosek, and Pasternak can't throw it off a member of the Kraken into the goal from a bad angle. Here's Everly to McCann, and Ullmark takes it away. Pasternak. Giordano picks it off. Marcus Johansson glides into the right wing corner, backhands it around for Giordano, who won the Norris in 2019. Bergeron kicks to Marchand, to Craig Smith. McAvoy to Marchand. McAvoy to Smith. Marchand over the bar, and it lobs in back of the goal.
Both teams look like they had sure goals, one at each end.
McAvoy to Craig Smith, to McAvoy, slips it to Grizzlick, down low for Marchand. Smith's one-timer bounces through the goal mouth. Grizzlick to Craig Smith. Good zone time for the Bruins here. Jordan Everly skates it to center. Batted away by Grizzlick. Marchand couldn't keep it on his forehand. Dunn around to Adam Larson. Yanni Gord. Yarncroc tries to feed Appleton. Steen gives to Coyle. Uses the long reach to get around Yanni Gord. Forbert jumps down into the corner. Dunn gets sandwiched by Steen and Coyle. Adam Larson to Appleton. Gord indirect. Forward blocking Appleton's centering attempt. Appleton sizzles it offline. Lauzon rescues the puck. Yarncroc. I'll get it out of the way. That literally means iron hook in Swedish. Omark covers. 11:58 to go, first period. Good tempo to start this game at TD Garden. All right, we're back. They resume play.
Yeah, that was a puck that came in on Omark from behind the red line, I believe.
Yep, the red light was on, so we went. You didn't miss much.
Defensive zone draw, Boston. Clean breakout. Action on.
Erholm Bakkanainen round through the corner. Dunn's shot deflects. I think it was Geeky in front. Lazar ridden off by Blackwell.
Vakanainen's got to make a better decision. Nobody on that side of the ice except Vince Dunn.
Shan back to Giordano. Colin Blackwell attempts the self-pass off the corner boards. Nilsson wise to that. Adam Larsson jamming down in the corner. Goes head-to-head for a moment with Taylor Hall. It was a one-for-one trade. Hall to New Jersey from Edmonton, which is picked him first overall in 2010. Icing against Seattle.
Yeah, you got a pretty good idea of the commitment to defense early in the hockey game by Seattle. Defense being pinching down the walls in the offensive zone. I'll put that in the defensive category, Jack. But then right there, Pastrnak tries to make a rush for Seattle Kraken and surround him. No options for Pastrnak. Puck turns over.
McAvoy. Marchand swirls. McAvoy's one-timer blocked. Marchand lifts the pass for Grizzlick. Grizzlick centers, looking for Craig Smith.
May have been deflected just a touch.
McAvoy out high. Three men along the blue line for Boston. Johansson camps over the puck, enabling the lob to center. McAvoy, miscommunication. Eberle shot off the webbing of Ullmark's glove. Possession for Boston, and the penalty gets called. 9:44 to go, first period. We promise you, you won't
Boston,
miss
number 73,
anything.
Minor penalty for tripping.
Game, given the opportunities. Clearing attempt by the Kraken is going to deflect off the body or skate of David Pastrnak and end up going right like a perfect pass to Taylor Hall. Taylor Hall probably didn't get as much on it as he wanted to as he tried a quick release and then off the rush, kind of a 2-on-0, Eberle and McCann. That puck was kind of up in the air and bouncing. And then this sequence here, nice little give and go. McAvoy, Marchand, Smith gets a first opportunity, Marchand on the second opportunity. Oh, great save and goal, Drieger. Not once, but twice.
Giordano to the bumper, McCann. Johansson's pass tipped to the corner by Forbert. Carlo jumps on it and bounces it across corner.
Aggressive at the right time, deep in the zone. Forbert, Carlo, good read.
Jordan Eberle with Johansson rushing up the gut. Johansson takes the puck, centers it to Gord. Gord around the boards, nobody home. Giordano pressured by DeBrusque. DeBrusque changes out. Nilsson and Lazar up front with Riley and Vakanainen, the defensive pair on the penalty kill. Vakanainen blocks it away from Johansson. Giordano whips the backhand off Yarncroc's stick. Nilsson. Sweet feed for Lazar. He checks. Riley is rushing. Riley backing up. off the strings wide.
O'Reilly explosive to get into that play to create that 2-on-1. Good effort. He hung around just long enough. He knew he had to start getting back. You down a man. Hung around long enough to get a chance at the side of the net.
Here goes Marchand off to the races. Vince Dunn rides him to the center of the zone, and Marchand throws it to open ice to waste some clock. Forward. The puck to the dot. Carlo uses leverage on Vince Dunn.
That's a guy that wanted the puck in that situation. Used his reach, his strength, his size, and his will.
Less than 10 seconds to go in Seattle's power play. Wennberg tips it up the boards. Donato jams against Grizzly. Vakanainen off Grizzly into the middle. McAvoy knocks it down for Fogarty. Stephen Fogarty throws it right wing corner.
That's a heads up play by McAvoy coming out of the box. He knows he can make a hand pass in this situation in his own zone.
Jonas Donskoy offline for Sheahan. Oscar Steen feeds Fogarty over to Bleed. Bleed to Fogarty off the apron of the goal. Cale Fleury, who's Hayden's younger brother by 2 years. Number 8 goes on to Sheahan. McAvoy takes the hit to move the puck. Nosek gallops. Pasternak off Nosek's skate. Paul speeds over to rescue the puck. Riley comes off the boards. Vakanainen steps past Sheahan. The puck goes slot. Appleton clears.
Looked like Vakanainen wasn't sure what Nosek was going to do. Kind of got in his way.
Donato sizzles one. Appleton catch and release to Gord. Ooh. The play is ruled offside.
Gord thought he was in possession of that puck.
Yep, I thought so too. 6:21 to go in the first.
Celebrating Hockey is for Everyone night here at TD Garden, and tonight's Kid Captain brought to you by Arbella is Gavin Ford, and Gavin plays for the Boston Ice Storm, which is a sled hockey team, and ICE actually stands for Include, Compete, and Empower, because this team includes people of all disabilities to help them play the great game of hockey. You can find a link to donate to the team at Nesson.com. 100% of the proceeds go to the team for equipment and things that they need. And Kid Captain is brought to you by Arbella Insurance. Here for Bruins fans, here for good. You can nominate a kid to be a captain at bostonbruins.com/kidcaptain.
Great story, Sophia. And if you ever have a chance to watch sled hockey, do it. You talk about combat in the slot.
I tell you, they're unbelievable athletes.
Remarkable. Craig Smith says hello to Jonas Donskoy. Carlo to Riley. Bergeron blocked by Drieger. Marchand off a stick, off Bergeron's glove, back to center. Hard around, and the Bruins change out all 5 skaters. It's the coil line, flanked by DeBrusque and Steen. McAvoy and Grizzly, the D pair. Yarncroc deflects the pass to Gord. I thought Gord was in possession and control of the puck.
Yeah, he might have already been in the offensive zone when he received the pass.
Yeah.
And I think that's why the offside was called. He didn't receive it and carry it in behind him. He was already in the zone.
What a terrific player Yanni Gord is.
I think he's the most dangerous guy in Seattle's lineup tonight.
Boyle off Grieger's stick, off back glass, and here is Yanni Gord. Had a tremendous year in 2018, 25 goals, 39 assists, and then John Cooper asked him to move down in the lineup, and he's got 2 marvelous rings for doing that. McCann around the horn, Giordano Adam Larson tees it up. Whoa, good hands from McCann. Johansson with a doorstep chance.
And he got caved in from behind, and I think that changed, you know, the position of the blade of his stick.
Giordano takes the hit from Nosek.
Yeah, it was delayed offside, free clear for Boston.
Taylor Hall, Pasternak, tries to lift it over Dunn, nothing doing. Morgan Geeky, the ex-Kane. Stephen Fogarty picks it up off Lausanne's stick to the blue line. Bleed keeps it in the attacking zone. Gets run into by Riley Shan. Dunn, really good hands on this guy. Colin Blackwell, Hobbit man. Through the corner, Anton Bleed, good position on the body to prevent Donato from getting close to the puck. Drieger stops it. Hayden Fleury up the boards. Hayden and Cale Fleury paired in the NHL for the first time. Donskoy and Marchand go shoulder to shoulder. Winberg back to Hayden Fleury. Passes to his younger brother, Cale. Winberg to Donskoy. McAvoy twirls it through the corner. The cutback from Smith. One touch. Marchand to Bergeron. Grizzlick to Bergeron. Bergeron tries the short side, and Drieger has the puck in his body. 2.5 minutes to go. First period, zeros at TD Garden.
Between the dots. That was a nice acquisition by Boston to set up a deep playoff run in 2019. That's a third line combination. You know you got a good squad if you're that deep.
Johansson has a contract that expires at the end of the season.
You don't
Seattle's
say.
Not going to make the playoffs. Could we see history repeat itself? He was a magical match with Coyle, as you illustrated. Marchand closes, feathers the pass off Yarncroc. Smith off Appleton's stick. Larson indirect to Yarncroc. Cross corner. And that's offside.
No, it's icing, I believe.
Side.
Yeah, that was from behind the red line. Tried to go cross corner and did not get the benefit of the follow through. See if Boston can take advantage of it. Choose the side you want to take it with Coyle in the middle. He wants to go to his backhand side, right circle. I mean, in the old days where that puck was fired from, probably the faceoff automatically on the other side. But with the choice, maybe you get a play off the faceoff here.
Coyle won it to DeBrusk right where he was. Vaakanainen's shot knocked down in front. Loose puck. Vaakanainen finds it first. The backhand to Coyle. He's planted by Lausanne. Yanni Gord. Coyle going after him. Lausanne to Yarncroc. Retreats. Indirect to Lausanne. Banks the pass to Appleton. He gets upended by DeBrusk. Toe picking is in style for Seattle tonight. Vince Dunn off Taylor Hall's stick. Johansson lifts it to the right wing corner. Everly digs it free. McAvoy tears it away from Everly. Off Nosek's skate. Everly to McCann. Taylor Hall following McCann. McAvoy into Hall's skates. Final minute. Johansson can't pick the corner on Omar.
Save of the period. On timeliness alone.
Hall, Pasternak. Hall off the boards. Hard stop. Gets away from Adam Larson. Nosek over Riley's stick. Erickson to Hayden Fleury. Banks the pass. Donato leaves it for Alexander Wennberg. Hayden Fleury. Larson, 15 seconds to go. Hayden Fleury off Donato's blade. Omar stops, heartbeats, inches below the top of the glass, and they will go to the room 0-0 after 20 minutes.
The biggest stop was Omach in the final minute, Jack. The Bruins had an opportunity to make plays through the neutral zone. They couldn't quite execute, and that allows Johansson to get open on the weak side. McAvoy can't get back in time. Strong net drive. Omach well positioned, trying to stay as big as he could, even when he went into the umbrella, into the butterfly, and was able to get it with the right arm. Big stop. But I'll tell you, Jack, for those of us that were excited to see what this Kraken team was all about in person, they were impressive in the opening 20 minutes.
Yep. They're building a club the right way. Dale, Billy, and Razor with you after this short break. Heading into the second period, Sophie Yurkovich, what is the next question in Predict the Game?
I love these Predict the Game nights, and it is indeed a Predict the Game night. You guys can head over to nesson.com/predictthegame. It's not too late to join because correct answers are going to be worth 200 points going forward, and you guys are competing for a signed Patrice Bergeron puck and $250, so why not play, Jack? The question is, speaking of Patrice Bergeron, who's of course going to the All-Star Game for the Boston Bruins, will Patrice Bergeron record a point in the second period? I'm giving it a thumbs up yes.
The Bruins have had some good looks, and the captain has been part of him.
Yeah, he's been all around the puck. He's been all around the net. It just hasn't translated into a goal. Here he tries to make a play to the front of the net. Hope you get a good bounce. That went off done and just wide. Nice puck battle win below the goal line. Look for Craig Smith on the net drive. Shorthanded. He and Marchand off the rush. He tried to go backhand, forehand to get a quick shot. Wasn't able to finish the play. Here again, he forces the turnover and a puck battle behind the net. Nice little give and go. Neat little feed on the backhand by Craig Smith. Back to the Bruin captain. Try to sneak one short side. All around it. Nothing to show for it in the first 20. Could very well change here in the middle period.
Bruce Cassidy sends out Tomasz Nosek, Taylor Hall, David Pastrnak to start. Dave Hakstol sends out Alexander Wennberg, flanked by Jonas Donskoy and Ryan Donato. Nosek bats to Vince Dunn, Pastrnak to Hall. Hall intercepted by Donato, flips it off the boards, and it bounces all the way to Nosek. Riley, Hall, Dunn gloves it to Nosek, hauled down. Wennberg, Nosek intercepts. Donato, pocket picked by Carlo. Lauzon past the red line. Ryan Donato deflects it. DeBrusque laterally. Oscar Steen can't get it past Cale Fleury. Hayden, his older brother, comes cross ice. Gorge dishes to Yarncroft. Gord trying to chop it past Coyle. Hayden Fleury down to the hash marks. Yanni Gord feeds it right into the slot. DeBrusque takes the ice in front of him. Coyle spoons it past Hayden Fleury. DeBrusque nudges toward the front of the goal. Gord dumps it past forward. Fakanainen covers for his D pair. Is down after the hit by Gord.
Now Gord finished his check, and Vakanainen's head rattled across the glass.
And forward volunteers to take Gord's head off.
Yeah, Vakanainen went below the goal line. He took a look. He saw Gord come, and he knew the contact was coming. But the contact was a finish high and hard on the backside, and his face went directly into the glass.
Injury to the head, and he is leaking.
Now we'll take a look. There's the look over the left shoulder. He knows it's coming. That's where you got to come in and do the bear hug. I mean, that's on the numbers, and the finish gets up high into the glass. The referees should really get together here and make a penalty call.
Five for boarding is my guess.
Well, they're getting together. Jack, what do you expect? A 5-minute board and then review?
Yep. Distance covered, time to pull up, as you said, do the bear hug.
Yeah, it wasn't a late spin on the puck where you're already committed to the hit. There's enough time there to go in and just bear hug and ride him in.
Gord isn't a dirty player, but that was bad judgment in little time.
We do have a major penalty call in the play. We're going to look at it.
Eric Forlatt with the announcement. We've seen this three times in recent games, and this is the right procedure.
Yeah, and based on our analysis here, I mean, he's got time to make a different decision. And this is a poor decision, and it's a bad result. So they make the major call, the 5-minute major, after consultation with the four officials on the ice. And I think this 5 minutes should stand.
Yep.
You know, the position that Vaakanainen is in, given where the puck is, and his want to make the right play, which is to reverse the puck, is in a very vulnerable position, and there's enough distance and enough time for Gord to make a different decision.
And the player on the puck, Vaakanainen, did not spin
right,
or alter his body position
right,
at any point in that sequence.
Yeah, I think the 5 minutes got to stand here.
Yep.
I mean, I understand you want to finish your tech, you want to get in, make body contact, but that's just, they don't want that hit in the game, and here's your opportunity to reinforce that.
Yep. At the rate they're going, Vaakanainen may have the stitches out by the time they make a decision.
Yeah, the stitches is the least of the concern.
Yeah.
You know, it's a hit
yeah,
to the head into the glass.
Yep. I mean,
that's where your concern is.
Yep.
You know, you can sew a guy up. But...
spoken like a true hockey player.
Yeah, this is taking too long. I think they're overthinking this one
yep,
here. That's a
yep,
5-minute major.
Yep.
I know you want to get it right, but.
Okay. Chislaine Hébert. Nope.
After further review, a minor penalty for boarding has been awarded.
I disagree with that call.
Yeah, Forlatt on the announcement. Wow. What? It begs the question, what is a boarding major?
You know, I watch a guy like Bergeron. We use him as an example most things in this game. You know, everybody calls him, oh, Mr. Perfect. But he was on the receiving end of a nasty career life-threatening hit.
Randy Jones.
Right, okay. And it was before all the new changes in penalties.
Right.
But you watch him go in. When he has an opportunity on a vulnerable guy, he goes in with a bear hug.
Right. Right.
And most players should and learn to do that more often in this game. And the best way to do that is to keep the 5-minute major call on
right,
Gord.
Right. Make it a significant penalty.
Well, the referee's got, you know, the procedure right. Just not sure if that's, you know, the 2-minute call is the proper call.
Paul shovels it right on Drieger and Bergeron. Pasternak shoots. Drieger, a blocker save. Hall. Pasternak. Pasternak's bomb off Larson's leg. Bergeron, the puck retrieval. Pasternak whips the puck right into Jonas Donskoy. He closes. A glove save by Omark. Dumps it out right away. Bergeron headmans the puck to Marchand. Swerves across the attacking zone. McAvoy's drive in and out of Drieger's glove. Pasternak, puck retrieval, lifts the pass to McAvoy. Cross ice, Bergeron, the one-timer off Marchand's feed. Blackwell tosses the puck off the left wing boards. McAvoy checks Blackwell out of the play. Marchand gains the line. Coyle taps to Pasternak. Wennberg gets his stick in there, and Lauzon clears. Grizzlick with 35 seconds to go in the man advantage. Puts on the brakes. Coyle to Pasternak. Pasternak, the shot. Loose rebound, and DeBrusque had a couple of pokes at it, but first Krieger settles the puck.
Some good action in the offensive zone. The man advantage for Boston, and Pasternak's going to go in a battle for a loose puck. A little chop down on the stick of Donskoy. Thought he was going to get a penalty there, Jack. Didn't happen. Donskoy got his stick back, makes a steal on a backhand attempt across the ice by Pasternak. You think if he's ever going to score a goal, it would be right here. He tried to go short side. Glove saved by Omark, another important one. And then Coyle out at the top. He sets up Pasternak. Pass was too hard to be a one-timer. Pasternak regroups, goes for the drag, snap, rebound. DeBrusque had a couple swipes at it.
Jonas Donskoy, over the last four seasons, per game, per 82 games, has averaged 19 goals. This is his 44th game of this season. He hasn't scored yet for Seattle. Riley off Coyle's skate in the slot. Giordano belts it all the way to the Boston zone. Gord, fresh out of the box, takes a poke at Grizzlick. Three shots on goal during the Bruins' power play. Craig Smith crisscrosses with Jake DeBrusque. Riley, the shot into Drieger's glove. Bruins Rock, presented by Plymouth Rock, the official auto insurance program of the Boston Bruins. David Pasternak scored 12 goals in 16 games in the first month of the year. He's done that three times, scoring a dozen in a month. Now Fogarty wins the drop and wants to go with Gordon. Lazar takes over.
We got another one along the wall here in front of the Zamboni doors, Jack.
Forward takes the brunt of a Lauzon punch.
Well, if the referees aren't going to get it right, the Bruin players certainly want to.
Yep.
And this happened right at puck drop. Gord, the center. Go back to see this hit by Gord. You know, Gord thinks that's okay. Again, we reiterate, he had other options. Lazar getting in there. Started with Fogarty, but Lazar wanted more of it. He got in there, and then as that was ending, away from the play, it was Lauzon and Forbert. See how this shakes out. Watching the linesman pick up the puck, and where are we going for the faceoff? If they're heading to the Boston zone, it could be Boston shorthanded.
Well, what's the saying? We'll kill that 2 minutes. Again, you know, what is a boarding major?
Yeah, well, I'm done explaining that. That's, you know, they got it wrong. But on this face-off, you know, it was interesting to watch Fogarty in the middle. You know, this is one of those face-offs you don't care if you win it. You take a shot at winning it, and then you attack the guy that you're facing it off against because it's Yanni Gord for the hit on your teammate, Vaakanainen.
Bruins shorthanded. Lazar booked for an extra two. No announcement yet. Bergeron wins the drop against Johansson. McAvoy with the 200-foot clear. Jared McCann, pestered by Marchand, goes down in the corner. Yarncroc to Eberle. Carlo stands him up. Gets the puck back. Giordano to McCann. One touch wide. Marchand skates onto it. Bergeron cruising the middle. Marchand bumps his way loose. Bergeron looking for Marchand. Johansson was there. Marcus Johansson off Carlo's skate. Johansson in the corner feathers the pass for Eberle to Johansson. Omar can't grab it. Eberle banks the pass to McCann. Eberle closes right through the slot. Dunn, the defenseman. Donskoy to McCann to Eberle behind the back. McCann fires through traffic. Dunn, good effort from Coyle. Seattle gets the quick re-entry. DeBrusk shortens the stick to take the puck. Jonas Donskoy has the angle. DeBrusk dumps it deep. Less than half a minute to go in the penalty kill for Boston. Bleed and Nosek up front. Riley and McAvoy, the D pair. Donskoy into the circle. Bleed can't clear. The one-timer Geeky. Donskoy had a second chance and Omar was there. Boston has killed it in 2 seconds. Lazar on his feet and out the gate after a two-shot power play for Seattle. Hayden Fleury over the spoked B. Drills it around. Wenberg takes the brunt of McAvoy's check. Adam Larson paddles it to the corner. Riley, Larson centers. Good stick, McAvoy. Geeky indirect. Hayden Fleury, gloves stopped by Omar. 13:33 to go, second period. We're still looking for the game's first goal. Championship matters. Sophia.
I heard you say it before, but Hayden and Cal Fleury, brothers, and playing together on the same sheet of ice together, not against each other, because they have played against each other in the NHL in the past, but as teammates for the first time in their history. They were both chosen in the expansion draft when Seattle joined the league. And Cale, this is his first game with the Kraken. He was called up because of some COVID issues, so he gets to play with his big brother. Mom and dad must be proud. It's a big hockey family and a big moment for them. Congrats to the brothers.
There's Hayden on the left point, Cale on the right. Off. Gord closes. Can't go forehand, backhand. Cale confronted by Steen. Seattle advances. Gord around to Hayden Fleury. Smacks it reverse. DeBrusk. Cale Fleury checks him. Puck squirts to Yarncroc, blocked by Carlo. It was also off DeBrusk's stick. Appleton back to Hayden Fleury off a couple of Boston blades. Steen chucks it off the boards. Larson, Appleton knocked down by Coyle, intercepted by Marchand. Puck gets away. Ryan Donato, Alexander Wenberg backs to the boards. Gets checked by Smith. McAvoy to Marchand. Puck bounces around. Grizzlick to Bergeron. He sails the backhand off end glass. Giordano dodges Marchand. Adam Larson rushing the puck. Gains the line. Drops it to Donskoy. Smith corrals him to the corner. Giordano to Larson. The shot blocked in the slot. Smith, Marchand has Bergeron far side. Donskoy knocks down the airborne pass. Jonas Donskoy strides into the Boston end. Carlos stacks him up. Seattle changes behind that rush. Tomasz Nosek past the red line. One hands it to Riley. Cross ice Hall. Deeks on McCann. Nosek to Riley. Tees it up. A save by Drieger. Dunn tries to hit Johansson. Johansson gets his stick in. Carlo skates. Carlo goes down. And Nosek takes an awkward fall. The Bruins to the power play.
Seattle, number 90, Minor Penalty, tripping.
Yeah, you don't like to take offensive zone penalties if you can help it. This is one of those cases where Johansson's going to go to the box. Carlo looking to make a play on the puck. Little cutback. Sticking the skates. Down goes Carlo. Boston with the man advantage. You know, talking to the people that cover this Kraken club, Jack, they say when they get down in hockey games, you know, no matter how hard they work, and they work hard, and they're well coached, and they're disciplined, but because of the lack of a finishing touch, I mean, they're decent offensively, but when you get them down, it's difficult for them to come back. Here's the Bruins in a 0-0 game on a power play halfway through the tilt. Power play goal could go a long way in winning this hockey game right now.
Hall to Pastrnak, he scores! His 10th power play goal of the season. Pastrnak's 21st overall. Of the 16 teams in the playoff structure, the Bruins are the most dependent on their power play for their total offense.
Right, you just got to love the setup here. It's McAvoy working the blue line. Get to the middle of the ice. You have so many more options at the top of that umbrella. And then a nice little feed over to Marchand on the elbow. Now try to create two-on-ones, and if there's a seam pass available when you attack the net from the low side over by the goal line, Pastrnak's going to be in position for the one-timer, and it's a heads-up feed from Taylor Hall, and it looked like the puck actually was deflected by Seattle, Jack. I think Pastrnak was going glove side, but it looked like it deflected off one of the penalty killers' stick and changed direction.
Bruins' goal was brought to you by Audi.
See if we can get a look at it from this angle. The seam pass will be there. Pastrnak poised. Yeah, right there off Donskoy, I believe. And it goes different direction. It goes blocker side instead of glove side. You take him any way you can get him. I know it's February 1. Maybe another dozen this month for 88.
Boston goal score on the power play.
Grizzly wrists it and rides the dasher. Lazar checks done. DeBrusk flips it to Lazar. Lazar gets away from Geeky. Cycle by DeBrusk. The one-timer McAvoy. Grizzlick punches it down to Coyle. Through the corner. Lazar with leverage on Lazar. Grizzlick around Blackwell. Coyle across ice. McAvoy had the puck skip on him. Lazar beats DeBrusk into the boards.
Nice saucer from Coyle. Long distance. McAvoy coming in the backside.
Dunn off Geeky's backhand. Matt Grizzlick to Brad Marchand. Cross ice. McAvoy clubs it around. Cale Fleury, Hayden Fleury, back to Cale, indirect behind Donskoy. Bergeron scrapes it back. Forbert can't clear the zone. Donskoy deep. Riley, good read, good stick. Cale Fleury to Hayden Fleury. The wrist shot. Gloves stopped by Ullmark. 9:15 to go, second period. David Pastrnak breaks the ice in this one. For Bruins hockey, here for good.
Yeah, I always appreciate this look because you get a pretty good idea of how close things are to being completed in terms of scoring goals, the pace of the game, the action in and around the net. We've seen it at both ends of the ice in both periods. I mean, this is a 1-0 hockey game, but it could be 3-3 at this point with the chances both clubs have had.
There it is, the ankle cam. Seattle's points percentage is 32nd out of 32 teams when allowing the game's first goal. Bruins have a 7.62 points percentage when scoring first. The league average is 7.29. Jared McCann around the circle. Vince Dunn to Jeremy Lauzon. His stick shatters. Grizzlick out battles Eberle. The puck squirts past the dot. Craig Smith interrupted by Dunn. Oh, Johansson took a friendly fire stick. I think it was Dunn's stick. I may be mistaken, but Eberle's.
Yeah, it sure looked like a teammate stick and not a Bruin.
Yep.
Yeah, that's like a spear to the neck or the face. Certainly unintentional, but his teammate. Grizzlick putting the body contact at the blue line on Eberle, and Eberle comes right off the point of the blade of the stick right to his teammates. Man.
Didn't mean it. Giordano battles the puck. Riley, good read. Yarncroc. Giordano off bleed stick. Carlo's going to go for interference on Mason Appleton. Yarncroc digging the puck out of the corner, and the call comes. It is indeed interference in the interpretation of Eric Furlatt.
Boston 25, Montrepelling interference.
Now, Carlo's got to square this puck up with his right hand. You know, he's got to make contact with this puck and knock it back in the other direction. When he doesn't and it gets behind him, now he's at such a disadvantage. He wants to just run a little bit of contact, a little bit of interference with Appleton, and then release him and try to compete for the puck. But the contact lasted a little too long. Appleton goes down, as does Carlo. Call goes against Boston for interference. You know, that high lob has been a problem for the Bruins a little bit, Jack. You know, it's hard to simulate that in practice to work on it, but, you know, it's a difficult play for a defenseman.
More and more teams are using it. McCann catch and release. Eberle denied by Ullmark. Good, strong push left to right. Lazar locks up Yarncroc's stick, and McAvoy clears. Giordano, the year after he won the Norris, he won the Mark Messier Leadership Award. Patrice Bergeron won it last season.
He was undrafted, wasn't he?
Yep. Amazing. Gord tees it up. Yarncroc blocked by McAvoy. He doubles over in pain. That left a mark. Halfway through the power play, Donskoy chucks it to Geeky, paddles it back to Dunn. The one-timer, Donato, a billiard shot. Dunn slaps it back to Donskoy. Around the boards, Donato tries to feed Wennberg, and Jake DeBrusk gets under the puck and goes to the box for delay of game. 38 seconds of 5-on-3. McAvoy. It's only a flesh wound. Gets up and Cowboys over the boards.
Well, the Bruins are, you know, doing a decent job killing this penalty. It's good stick position by DeBrusk. I thought maybe that that puck was helped over the glass, but obviously not. We'll go back to the opportunity. Nice puck movement. Top of the umbrella, elbow to elbow, quick release. And then they set up the one-timer for Iron Hook.
See how Seattle works the 5-on-3. Giordano off the corner boards, wide of the goal, and it bounces all the way back. Seattle has 2 5-on-3 goals. The Bruins have allowed 2 this season. It's offside at the line.
That's a pet peeve for me, Jack. You know, I mean, it's okay to miss the net when it's late in the power play. And, you know, as long as the guy is going to break away out of miss. But 5-on-3, you don't want, and you only got 38 seconds of 5-on-3. You don't want to lose 10, 11, 12 seconds, whatever it is, by missing the net. I know you're trying to score a goal, but you're doing the three-man penalty-killing group a huge favor by missing the net in that situation.
Especially with guys like McCann, Everly, Gord out there. McCann had that great catch and release moments before. Giordano's bomb, saved by Omark. Giordano dishes to McCann. Shattered stick. Forward, had he waited an extra second, Carlo would have had a walk-in.
And that would have been fun to see.
Jonas Donskoy goes around Derek Forbert. Around the perimeter, Morgan Geeky. Back to Vince Dunn. Intentionally wide. Forbert and Donato muck for the puck. Wennberg gets in the mix. Gets it back to Dunn. Cross ice. Geeky's one-timer. Off glass and a 200-foot bounce.
You know, the Giordano shot that he hit the net. Omark makes the save. There's a chance for a rebound.
Yep.
And now Geeky gets an opportunity. He misses the net again. Helps the Bruins kill the penalty. They still got work to do, though.
Done. 20 seconds to go. Geeky denied. The seam. Donato's one-timer blocked by Krizlik, and Coyle takes care. Appleton races up the right wing as DeBrusk gets out of the box. Colin Blackwell to Cale Fleury. Blackwell's shot. Omark makes that move when he goes down. He often jumps off his knees. 6'4", doesn't leave much goal to shoot at. Cale Fleury, spun around by Nosek, gets the puck out of the zone. Pasternak stirs it up the wing. Hall centers, Pasternak behind his back. McAvoy, Pasternak coming out high, gets the rebound off Blackwell. Nosek spins around Hayden Fleury, off Hall in front. Hall scores! The goals come about 7 minutes apart, bookending a vital penalty kill, and the Bruins extend the lead.
Yeah, they kill the 5-on-3, they kill the 5-on-4. I'll tell you, Noshik's had a real blue-collar period. A lot of hard work playing that second-line center position tonight with Hall and Pasternak. You know, he wins a puck battle down deep. He's just trying to keep this play alive. And now you got 3 cracking behind the goal line. They still have Riley Sheahan out in front, but he can't manage the puck. Hall's on him in a instant, and he just hammers a loose puck. Stick side to give the Bruins a 2-0 lead.
Taylor's first goal in 4 games. Timely. Bleed gets it up The left wing follows. Drieger sticks the puck to the end glass. Larson pins Nolsek. Bleed in the mix. Talk about blue collar effort. Fogarty willing to mix it up. 3:15 to go, second period. Taylor Hall gets into double figures.
Use that term blue call. This is a great example of it when you talk about Tomasz Noszczyk. Here he is below his own goal line, picks up a loose puck, take it to the wall, protect the puck, fight through that hit. Neutral zone, fight through that hit. Two players converge on you, punch that puck towards the boards where you get the support of Mike Riley. Now you read and react. Taylor Hall's down deep. I got to make an outlet. He goes to the wall by the hash mark. Now he's able to play that low to high game. Riley's able to tee one up, and Hall almost gets a tip on it. That's the way he's played all year, but a lot of that here in the second period.
A 29-year-old Czech signed by Boston in July as a free agent. Boost moment of the game. Make it your vaccine.com to find out where to get your booster shot. Riley's high drive blocked to the Zamboni doors by Drieger. Appleton looks for the puck, gets help from Larson. Coyle A-frames, gets space. Locked up with Appleton. Lazar goes in there, gets rubbed by Larson. And the rugby scrum continues. Lozon nudges to Appleton. Gord backward in his zone, gets the return from Larson. Appleton through Johansson's skates, or rather Yarncroc. We haven't seen Johansson since he took Eberle's stick in the neck. Giordano wrists it off a teammate. Riley lobs it ahead of DeBrusk. Dunn. Giordano, Gord, one touch. Vince Dunn on the go. The shot blocked easily by Ullmark into the netting.
All season, if you can't see the game broadcast live, it's not a problem. Catch a condensed two-hour version of all Nesson games every game night at midnight with Bruins in Two. Bruins in Two was presented by your New England Hyundai dealers.
Jared McCann against Patrice Bergeron. Giordano's drive blocked in the high slot. Eberle nudges to the end boards. Bergeron, great body position, boxing out Blackwell so Forbert could make the play. Off Marchand's skate, Dunn indirect passed. McCann, Eberle falling down, slides it to Blackwell. Lots of board battles here late in the second. Marchand to Bergeron, back to Marchand. The shot, glove save by Drieger.
Now stick with Nesson all this weekend for the latest news on Patrice Bergeron and your favorite All-Stars during the NHL All-Star Weekend. Coverage is presented by Cross Insurance. Your team, your choice. I mean, we're going to show you the offensive part of this shift, Jack. It's a little bit of a 3-on-2 coming across the blue line. Good effort by Marchand to get some separation. Bergeron puts it right on the tape in stride. Tries that back foot snapshot. Tries to go up around that left ear. But it was that defensive zone coverage by Boston. No panic.
Pasternak wheels it on Drieger. Final minute of the second period. The Bruins have scored twice. Pasternak, his 21st, and Taylor Hall, his 10th. So the All-Star Festival is centered on a 3-on-3 tournament, right?
Correct.
Who's the best 3-on-3 player in the league? Well, you have to discuss number 63. He's 13th in the league in scoring. although he's missed time twice. Nobody is more exciting than this guy. If you're showing off the all-stars instead of picking a Cub Scout from every troop.
I'm going to give you a reality perspective. I'm going to go back to that hit by Hathaway.
Yep.
On Marshawn, and even though he continues to play and perform, I want him taking that week off because he's playing in some pain.
The old Philly Flyers thing. Like, send Bill Barber to the beach for a week late in the season.
Yeah, we highlighted this game as a response to the 7-1 loss when Washington came in here. The Bruins, you know, we said they took hits and they gave hits. And this was a nasty hit that Hathaway got away with, but Marshawn has dealt with the upper body injury ever since that hit. He hasn't missed any time. He continues to perform. He's such a big part of what the Bruins are doing. He understands how important he is to the team. But yeah, I'm loving the week that he's going to get off. Start tomorrow.
Yep. Pack the suntan lotion. McAvoy off a leg, and it's 2-0 Bruins after 40 minutes.
Get the lead, extend the lead, keep the Kraken down. Do they have enough to come back? Bruins in good shape.
Billy and Razor with Dale Arnold in the fifth floor studio right after this. One-zero as we head to the third period. Marcus Johansson has come back to 2-0, I should say. Marcus Johansson has come back to the Seattle bench. In support of Hockey is for Everyone tonight, the Bruins used rainbow taped sticks for warm-ups. Bid for the chance to take a signed stick home. All proceeds from the auction will support the Boston Pride, New England's first LGBTQ plus hockey club. Head to BruinsAuctions.org to place your bids through February 9th. Tomáš Nosek wins the draw to open the third period. Chris Drieger fires it around through the corner. And what is the reason for the stoppage?
Looked like offside, I believe.
Oh, well delayed.
You know, your first inclination is when the puck gets wrapped around, it might have caught a little piece of the netting or something, but not where that faceoff was.
Ryan Donato to Jonas Donskoy. Carlos steps up. Long shot from Dunn. Hallmark alert to it. Pastrnak tries the short feed. Donato blocks it back. Carlo around for Riley. Paddles it off the boards. Wenberg, strong stick from Hall. The score by Donskoy. He finally lights the lamp. And first in 44 games.
And it's a good one. I mean, it's a bad start to the period for Boston. They haven't been strong on the puck. They've been lackadaisical in trying to move the puck to different teammates. And Donskoy is going to pick up this loose puck. I mean, the back pressure was good to force the turnover. And there's plenty of black and gold jerseys around the puck, but it's Donskoy through traffic. And he rips it high just under the crossbar on the glove side. He's had a good game. He's had great skating. He's been involved. He's been around the net. He's had chances. Had that beautiful shorthanded chance trying to go glove side low. Big smile on his face. Sense of relief.
He's a good player.
He is.
Marchand spoons it past Larson, only to have McCann there. McAvoy rattles it. McAvoy cross ice. Marchand, the tough angle. Drieger holds the short side. Everly sends McCann ahead, floats it off the boards, goes into forward's corner. Lazar finds it in his skates. Bergeron off the boards. The Bruins get a clean man-by-man change. Lazar finishes his check and flattens Hayden Fleury. Marchand battles it into the slot. Fancy move by Yanni Gourde. Gets it back from Appleton, gains the line, gives to Cale Fleury. Gourde in front, saved by Ullmark.
Now, Ullmark wasn't sure where it was. He thought he could feel it, and he knew he was deep in his net, and he pushed himself forward just to make sure that puck was not across the goal line.
Yarncroc making the bid.
Yeah, but again, the Bruins causing problems for themselves. Coverage not where it needs to be. When they had opportunities in the offensive zone, there was real no intensity to take the puck to the net. A little bit of a sleepy start to the third for Boston.
Blackwell nudges to Larson. Giordano's shot blocked by Lazar. Shan. Grizzlick finds some space, twists the wrists to Coyle, but he can't carry it out. Blackwell, the shot on save. Blackwell goes for a tumble. Giordano's laser goes off the strings. Grizzlick turns it to the corner. Geeky back to Larson. Giordano wrists it intentionally wide up on the strings. Lazar cross ice, too far forward for DeBrusque. Coyle backhands to the end wall. Onskoy and Donato up the right side. McAvoy tips it deep. Riley. Now McAvoy. Around the boards, intended for Bleed. Lauzon pins him. Fogarty slings it back to Riley. Along the line, McAvoy tipped out of the middle. Jonas Donskoy. Backhands to the slot. Donato trying to effort on goal. Riley flings the puck deep. Hayden Fleury throws the hip into Anton Bleed. Alexander Wennberg across the line, and it's offside. There's a new way to experience winter. Take the world's first mountain climbing train, the Washington Cog Railway, with 1 hour round trip daily departures all winter. Learn more at thecog.com. Pasternak decks Hayden Fleury, gets the puck from Grizzlick. Now Derek Forbert, indirect. Hall tries to get it out over the line and deflects, sending Nosek offside.
Nesson and Berkshire Bank are proud to celebrate Black History Month across the network. Throughout the month of February, Nesson will showcase and honor the many accomplishments and achievements of African Americans in New England sports history through short and long stories available on Nesson and Nesson.com. For more information, visit Nesson.com/Black History Month.
Grizzlick long indirect for Hall, does not connect. Hayden Fleury, Yarncroc gets a piece. Forbert digs it away. Hall. Yarncroc knocked it down with a high stick. Faceoff will come outside the Boston line. One goal game, 15:43 left in it.
Yeah, we talked, Jack, at the top of the broadcast about the mental toughness Boston showed coming out after that 7-1 loss to Carolina. All right, not a good game for Boston Sunday in Dallas. Looking for that mental toughness. They're going to get challenged here in the third period. They already are. Had a 2-0 lead. It's now 2-1. They're going to start establishing their game.
Bergeron on Driedger. And he clamps down on the puck. Giordano had a wicked collision.
Yeah, Bergeron just so smart. You know, he doesn't have much happening. Once he comes across the blue line, he gets pinched off. Takes a quick peek. Throw the puck at the net. Giordano on the back check. Marchand right there. That puck was loose. It was close to the goal line.
Couple of 37s at the dot. Ford and Bergeron. Ford wins the draw. Larson off glass. Riley. McAvoy draws Gord. D to D. Bergeron. Riley gets under it. Puck was wiggling, and that ends up in the ninth row.
Boston 63, minor penalty interference.
And Appleton didn't like this hit by Marchand when that puck was just up for grabs. Right around that offensive blue line, Marchand will go to the box. Appleton kept pursuing him once he got himself back together. Not sure what's wrong with that. It looked like Appleton was trying to make a play on the puck. Stick right in there on the puck, and Marchand just taking the body. Wow.
All right. Seattle has had 7 shots on goal during its 5 unsuccessful power plays. Forbert can't clear the zone. Giordano off Lazar's stick. Curtis Lazar nudges it. Seattle gets it back. Giordano, the wrist shot, stick to side by Omark. Giordano, the middle of the line. McCann, catch and release. Everly backhands it through the corner. Johansson back on the ice. Everly slides it back to Giordano, gets it back. Everly to Giordano. Everly looks for options. Giordano tipped through the middle, off glass, and catch in the netting.
Now we get a look from behind the Bruin goal. Giordano trying to go back across the body to the blocker side with that power eye right in front of the net. Deflecting up out of play.
Off yard croc. Coyle and DeBrusque, the penalty killing forwards. Grizzlick and McAvoy, the D pair. Stalemate. Yarncroc to Giordano. Eberle's wrist shot just wide on the glove side. McCann. Giordano to Eberle. Giordano's one-timer is saved by Omark. Eberle going for the one-timer off the rebound. Johansson regains the line. Coyle wraps up McCann and clears. Bleed Pester's done. Ryan Donato. Bleed from the back and Forbert from the front. Donskoy pokes it around. Geeky speeds it back to Dunn. Gets the puck back. Done. The one-timer, Gord, off goal. A big bounce off the corner boards. 2 shots on goal. Bergeron breaks in. We're back to 5-on-5. Yanni Cord. McAvoy keeps him on the perimeter. Lauzon's wrist shot off a stick and wide. Larson chucks it through the corner. Forbert pivots the puck. Smith can't advance it.
He thought he had Bergeron coming late, just kind of laid it back for him, but ended up being a turnover.
Lauzon feeds Colin Blackwell. Blackwell across the zone. Larson's shot scores. Mason Appleton ties the game with 12 and a half to go. The Bruins have frittered away a 2-0 lead.
Well, they get through the PK, and now they allow Seattle to tie the hockey game. We said, does Seattle have enough to come back? Well, they're showing you that they do, but Boston's helping them. Good puck movement, shot to the goal. Good bounce, deflects off McAvoy, finds the back of the net. I don't know if Appleton gets a piece of it or not. But this hockey game is tied. I think Boston's got to take a timeout here, Jack, and talk it over. Because it has not been a good third period for the Bruins. You know, you come into the final 20 knowing you got a big all-star break, 4, 5, 6 days, whatever it may be, depending on how much you're going to practice. An opportunity to reset. You want to go in with your 26th win of the season. Take a look at the standings during the break. Say, yeah, we're in pretty good shape. We had a great month of January. Let's keep it going February. You know, the schedule's going to be pretty good every other day once we get rolling again. And you got 20 minutes in front of you. And for the first 7.5, it has not looked good.
Nope.
Plays the puck and it's not ruled icing, so Boston cannot make a change. Make Valentine's Day special with New England's own Seacoast Sweets. Gift a box of peppermint, peanut butter, coconut, and s'mores patties. Visit SeacoastSweets.com. Pasternak throws the puck off the boards in the neutral zone. Lauzon indirect for Donato. Nosek had to hesitate so Hall could clear the zone. Donato, Forbert knocks him down. Centering pass, Grizzlick, one touch to Pasternak. Bruins get the puck out, but not gracefully. Forward, indirect, Grizzlick, Lazar, one touch, Coyle can't pick it up. Larson to Giordano. Carlo, DeBrusk off Coyle. Larson to Johansson off a stick, and that one ends up in the sixth row. 11:18 to go. We got a new hockey game. Point Parade. The iron of the team.
I'll take any one of those guys to step up right now.
Yep.
And add to those point totals.
Larson, indirect, intended for Appleton, DeBrusk. To Lazar, the shot, Driedger hugs it to his chest.
Yeah, a little bit too much towards the middle of the body on Driedger. good force in the neutral zone to turn this puck back in the offensive direction. DeBrusk able to hit Lazar with some speed. He attacks the net, get out to a shooting position around the dot. Looked like he wanted to go short side high. It was a little bit too central. Didn't want to miss the net. Sometimes that hits the goalie right in the chest. Lazar getting more duty on the right side with Coyle and DeBrusk tonight than we've seen in the past. Oscar Steen, not so much.
Riley through Lazar. Gord snaps it laterally. Riley off a skate. Coyle picks it up off Yarncroc and lofts it to the left wing corner. Gord does not connect. Lazar. Donskoy back into his own zone. The crowd trying to get the Bruins motivated. Steen slips it through to Bleed. Fogarty crashing the crease. Couldn't cash in.
Looked like Wenberg just got his stick in there.
Donato. Bleed throws him to the boards. Fogarty. Bleed.
There's a trip. Giordano's going to go.
McAvoy off the end boards. Bleed to Steen. Bleed indirect. The extra skater on for Boston. McAvoy along the line. Forward. Gets it back. Drills it. And it bounces off a couple of Seattle players. And we get the whistle. Bruins to the power play, trying to get their noses back ahead.
Seattle, number 5, minor penalty, tripping.
For Bruins Faceoff Live, presented by EchoStar Technologies. Get an in-depth scouting report on the Pittsburgh Penguins and all the latest Bruins news. EchoStar Technologies, vision, strategy, success. Yeah, Bruins all around the offensive net. Nice little play to the outside. Anton Bleed looking for Fogarty. Wenberg just barely got his stick into disrupt that pass, but Giordano went to the box for a trip. Bruins with a man advantage.
Pastrnak gets his own rebound off Yarncroc. Bergeron's bunt to the corner. McAvoy tosses it to Marchand. Bergeron to Pastrnak. He scores! David Pastrnak with 2 power play goals, both putting Boston ahead.
At first blush, I thought he was kind of catch and release looking for Taylor Hall on the weak side. But it's going to find its way into the net. Good keep-in by Charlie McAvoy. That's a great read. And then the quickness of moving that puck. Bergeron gets rid of it just quick enough. And I don't know if this was a shot, Jack. You'd have to ask David Pastrnak that. I thought he was just trying to catch and release, throw it in the direction of Taylor Hall. Maybe he knocks it down or tips one in or does something on that weak side. But Krieger gets a glove on it, but not enough.
100% of the shots not taken don't go in. Bleed mashes Hayden Fleury. Dale Fleury one hands it to Johansson, to McCann, to Hayden Fleury. And the Kraken are offside.
You know, we've seen Pastrnak catch and release, and you know when he's shooting and he's shooting to score. I thought he was reading how aggressive the penalty killers were being, and he just wanted to get it on that far side of the net. Again, kudos to McAvoy, quick movement. Yeah, I still think he's thinking in the direction of Hall. But that's what goal scorers do. They score goals when even when you don't think they're trying to.
Yeah. Jared McCann.
Boston goal.
Johansson gives it back. Vince Dunn. It's McCann. Pivots to Johansson. Tried the curl and drag on McAvoy. Nothing going there. DeBrusk closes off Lazar and wide. Grizzlick paddles it off. A Kraken player. Good decisions going up the ice. It looked like Lazar was going to dump it in once, dump it in twice, but he just maintained possession, kept it going forward, and then DeBrusk, good support on the read, pick up the loose puck behind him.
DeBrusk tries to shovel to Lazar. DeBrusk off his stick, and Drieger covers.
Monday, the 2022 Men's Beat Pod Tournament gets underway from TD Garden, only on Nesson. Starting at 5, Boston University faces off against Harvard. Then at 8, Boston College takes on Northeastern. Coverage of the Beanpot on Nesson is presented by Nissan.
Hall to Riley to McAvoy, cross ice, Pastrnak fouls it off.
That would have been true.
Donato to Giordano, reaches around Hall but can't get it in front. Nosek bounces the puck past Pastrnak. Giordano, red line, Wennberg, broken up. Nosek, who has been outstanding with his effort tonight. Giordano nudges to Wennberg. Cross ice, Larson. Yarncroc. Giordano looks for options, goes indirect to Yarncroc. Marchand steals, one on four, drops it, intended for Bergeron. Tally Yarncroc gets to the Boston line. Grizzlick now done. Zips it to Geeky. Rather Gord. Lauzon bumped by Forbert. Appleton swivels it around. Dunn reverses. Gord on the doorstep, can't handle the Appleton feed in traffic. Dunn's shot. Gord the knockdown backup tip just wide. Lauzon moving well. Gord's shot blocked out high. Marchand takes the puck to the red line. Lauzon stacks him up.
Yeah, that line needed a change.
Aiden Fleury cowboying over the dasher, and Marchand took exception to that. Stephen Fogarty stolen by Eberle. McCann's shot. The rip by McCann deflects off a stick, out of play. 5:35 to go. Bruins back out on top.
With his fingerprints all over the street, 2 lead for Boston. He got the first goal on the power play. Beautiful seam pass from Taylor Hall. One time it deflected off Donskoy. Finally back of the net on the block. Aside 2-2 in a third period where Boston had not played well. They actually used their timeout about halfway through because they had to get their act together. They got the benefit of the power play on the trip to Giordano. Catch and release, glove side. Another power play goal. Difference on the scoreboard right now.
16 power play goals in 14 games. And Boston's power play is going to hit the all-star break in stride. Carlo stopped at the red line. Giordano rattles it around. Carlo stacked up. Nosek finds Grizzlick in front. Steen skates the puck to the red line, gets it in deep. Donskoy spins away from DeBrusk. Lazar on the counter. Coyle just misses stick side. Coyle in the corner. Lazar Larson attacks the puck and rolls it out. Johansson around the boards. Everly. Marchand intercepts. Lauzon gets in his way. Craig Smith in front. Jared McCann. Jeremy Lauzon. Riley the keep in. Marchand turns to the forehand. And Trieger makes the save. Ford F-150 final five.
This is where all the discipline comes into play here, Jack. One goal lead, third period. I don't care who your opponent is. No turnovers around the offensive blue line. Strong on the puck. Force your opponent to have to go at least 200 feet. Make sure you have a third man high. No numbers in the opposite direction. And if you're going to shoot the puck, force the goaltender to make a save.
Three-point night for David Pastrnak. Two power play goals. And just added an assist on Hall's goal.
Yeah, I was hoping they would give a couple on that one. One to Pastrnak and one to Notion.
What's with the stingy scoring around the NHL this year? You know, we've had like an inadvertent touch be interpreted as possession.
Yeah, I mean, I know Riley Sheahan had the puck on his stick. He had a chance to make a play before Hall banged it home. But, you know, you like to reward guys for the hard work to get the puck in the neighborhood of Hall to have him finish the play.
It's a chaotic game. Hall to Nosek through Drieger's glove. Hall turns and fires, and Drieger has to make another save.
Stay with us after the game for Bruins postgame final, presented by Rodenheiser Home Services. Get in-depth insights on what's ahead for the black and gold. Stay in the know all season long with Bruins postgame final. Yeah, and if you're a winger, Jack, and Seattle's able to get that puck into the offensive zone, and you have to anticipate the pinches down the wall. You know, don't go to sleep in that area. Don't let the Kraken able to keep possession in the offensive zone and keep pressure on. Let the goaltender to get out, get that extra attacker on. You got to win those puck battles on the right front.
Carlo to Steen, Hayden Fleury in Steen's way. Carlo to Riley. Around the boards, Bleed makes the clear. Three minutes to go. Cale Fleury. McAvoy zips it around, and Craig Smith ices the puck.
Tune in for Bruins pregame shootout presented by Awaken 180 Weight Loss, your long-term solution for weight loss, next Tuesday night at 6. And hear thought-provoking opinions on the Bruins as well as the entire NHL from our hockey insiders. Catch Bruins pregame shootout next Tuesday night at 6.
Gordon Coyle. Marchand. The crowd thought he was deserving a penalty. Contact with Giordano. Giordano. Tries the stretch pass to Gord. Gord is on it. Goalie is pulled. 6-on-5. 2.25 to go. Vince Dunn. Yanni Gord. Dunn. The one-timer McCann, and a save by Omar. Johansson calmly to the far side. Jared McCann has made some nifty passes tonight.
And he can shoot it too.
Yep. Dunn to the dot. Everly, the one-timer into Grizzlick. Bergeron with the clear. And it deflected off the dasher and twirled into the second row.
Friday, don't miss a full night of men's Hockey East action. Starting at 7 on Nesson, Vermont takes on 16th-ranked Northeastern. And over on Nesson Plus, 17th-ranked Providence faces off against UConn. Presented by Rockland Trust Bank, where each relationship matters.
Seattle has taken its timeout. 1:48 to go. Solmark has made 25 saves.
You know, as players in this situation, Jack, you know, you got to love it on both sides. You know, if you're Seattle and the coaching staff has believability that I'm in the group that can, you know, tie this hockey game. You know, they value what I bring to the table. If we need to get a goal, I'm going to be part of the six of them. As far as the Bruins are concerned, you're trying to protect a one-goal lead. That means you have certain skill set that's going to allow us to defend, get pucks out along the wall, block shots if necessary, be aggressive, win your puck battles, and protect the lead, and maybe hit the empty net.
Bergeron, Coyle, Marchand, Forbert, and McAvoy in front of Linus Ullmark. Vince Dunn. Far side, McCann. The shot deflects wide. Coyle wins the puck. Forbert gallops onto it and angles the puck off the boards. Coyle prevents the clear in. Dunn off Coyle's stick. McAvoy, Everly had a chance, and Ullmark has the angle.
Coyle was in a, you know, a scrum, not even a scrum, like a play about 5 feet from the boards, right down below us at the defensive blue line. He got caved in from behind, and I think it was Everly that caved him in. That's why he's going back at him now, letting him know he didn't appreciate it. And it looked like the Bruins were going to get a real good break when Vince Dunn broke his stick yet. When he was trying to fire that puck in, it looked like Boston was going to get possession. You had Dunn going to the bench. All of a sudden, it's 5-on-5. But they can't manage the puck, and then Everly gets a shot away that the Bruins deflect out of play.
Gord trying to dig it out of many skates. Forward, McCann comes away with it. Giordano under Gord's forehand. Everly to Gord. Giordano, the one-timer. McCann missed a narrow target.
Reminded me that Clayton Keller played the other night in Arizona. Had a lot of net.
Giordano, 35 seconds to go. Seattle's goalie pulled. Forward to Carlo. Nosek throws it forward. Final rush. Vince Dunn speeds out of the Seattle zone. Gord tips it deep. Carlo will eat the clock. Final 10 seconds. Bergeron off the back of the goal. McCann tries to steer it front. And the Bruins will go into the All-Star break with a 3-2 win over the Seattle Kraken.
Well, Jack, I don't know how much the timeout had to do with it here in the third period. It certainly was necessary, but it was the power play that was the difference for Boston on the scoreboard. David Pastrnak in particular. The power play goal in the third period allows the Bruins to bank two more points. Not a third period to be ultimately proud of, but be proud of the fact that you did bank the 2 points. Your goaltender made some important stops. Your PP was big. You can see why the Kraken like what they're building. That was a pretty good effort by an expansion squad coming in here down 2-0. Easily could have quit. They made the Bruins earn this one.
Linus Ullmark with 25 stops. Save of the game brought to you by TD Bank.
Yeah, he was very good. And again, he just continues to win. And this was a timely save back in period number one. Bruins couldn't manage the puck at center ice. All of a sudden, Marcus Johansson's in all alone. Ullmark had good patience into the butterfly, but stayed big enough to get it with a right arm and blocker.
Dale, Billy, and Razor take us to vacation, Dale.